First, you're going to want to download all three zip files from the Sonic Pad Debian GitHub releases page. If you've never seen it before, this is a multi-part zip file, and you need all three files to extract the full contents. Next, download the PhoenixSuit flashing tools from the Creality GitHub page. Extract these zip files and open the PhoenixSuit software. In the Firmware tab, select the newly extracted .img file from GitHub. Next, connect one end of your USB-A to USB-A cable to the CAN port on the back of the Sonic Pad. Then, using a pin, press down the outermost recess button while turning the Sonic Pad on to put it in burning mode. Next, you need to install the drivers required for the PhoenixSuit to talk to the Sonic Pad. There are official Creality guides depending on your operating system, but the install steps basically entail setting up the drivers included in the PhoenixSuit's drivers directory. On Windows, you can use Device Manager. After the drivers are installed, you should get a pop-up from PhoenixSuit. If you don't, try restarting the Sonic Pad and putting it back into burning mode. It'll ask you if you want to format the device, press Yes. After about 10 minutes, the process will complete. Afterwards, you can connect to Wi-Fi using the screen and obtain your internal IP address. Using this, we can SSH into the Sonic Pad using the default credentials and start configuring. The first step is to expand the file system to the full 8GB size and update all packages. After that, you can use the Clipper Install and Update helper to install the 3D printing software you need and begin configuring Clipper. Happy printing!